for materials which you are using in the practical. So we're having the paper. First we are talk about the paper. So paper is a normal, not is the not a normal paper, it's a different type. So it may be impregnated paper, it may be a solid paper. Okay, so we have the different types of the paper. So whatever we're using the for writing paper, okay, that's also one of the insulator. But if it does not withstand the voltage, okay, so for that one we have to take the different types of the measurements while using the high voltages engineering. So here we have in the, so here we can see that, so the kind of paper is normally applied for. Okay, so the kind of thermal applied, you can see. So what are the specification, okay, which type of the paper we have to use. So the implied paper should be in a special way. Okay, whatever it is in, it's in a special paper. Okay, so in that paper we are using the different types. So that is a low density paper which having the 0.8 grams per centimeter cube, and they to having the high shape. So here, so our paper is mainly in the capacitor. So you have the capacitor, right? In that capacitor, the paper, okay, the paper roll will be like this. Okay, impregnate paper will be used, paper roll. So if you open the capacitor, so mainly most of the capacitor will be using the paper type insulation. So that is the dielectric material which are using, that is a paper type. So in that one, the rolling paper will be combined and placed. So first end and last end will be connected in the dielectric layer. Okay. So here, that frequency is also different. So here, if we take the density paper, if you take, okay, based upon application, the density of the paper will be different, one to another. Okay. And this is the one thing. And one more thing, papers. So we have different types. One is the normal paper, okay, dry insulating paper is not used. So we have to using the impregnated paper. So what are the dry paper? So let me take. So if the writing paper is there, okay, so writing paper is the thickness different, okay, and density is different. So if you take the insulator, if you use the whatever the paper is there, so if you are using as a transformers, so here if you take the transformers, right, so in the transformers, so if you draw the, sorry, so U-shaped, so U-shaped line, so whatever the core is there, so core is made up of the silicon sheet, right? So in that core, so what we are going to, you are using as the insulation for each core, it is insulating with one to other. So how it will be insulating means, so whatever the core is there, so if the U-type core is there in that one, for every lamination, so in between the we are placing the paper, so that paper is the different. So if a normal paper used, okay, whatever the writing the paper if you use, okay, that will not work. So that's why we are treating the impregnated paper. So we have to put it impregnation. So impregnation means nothing but, so paper is dipped into the oil. Okay, so paper is dipped into the oil. So in that one, the dielectrical strength of that will have in the solid. Okay, so whatever the mu r is there, that will have in the two, that is the solid we have it. So we will have in the solid, okay, so we will have in the solid as well as liquid. Okay, we have the two types of dielectric strength for the paper, that is we have the paper that is a solid as well as liquid dielectric property. Okay, that's why the dense high voltage is there. Okay, the whatever the energy storage is there. Okay, that is a different. So while using the capacitors, the application is different. Okay, if you use the transformer core, okay, so if it is the lamination sheet there, okay, so for the lamination of the paper, you see each lamination is separated by the thick papers, okay, impregnated paper. So because if you use the normal paper, whatever the paper is there, so that is dipped into the transformer. So while core is dipped into the transformer tank, right, so in the tank also it will be different. So to avoid that, so what we are doing, so we have to using the, that if the core is there. So core is whatever the core shape is there, same type of the core, so as the shape is there, so that shape of the paper also you use. Okay, Okay, let me take here. So in the dial question, so we had that. So paper, whatever the paper is, that will be solid. Dielectric properties there as well as liquid. So whenever if you use impregnate paper, that is we have two types of the strains. That is a mu or it is a different. Okay. So based upon application, it will be different. So for high voltage engineering, so paper mainly use that is impregnate paper. So whenever you use it for high voltage application, that is the impregnate paper use. So as well as a cable, if you take the cables. Okay. So cables also. Let me draw the front view. Okay, cross sectional. So if it is cables, conductors. So in the paper, whatever the paper is for cables. Okay, so surrounded that will be impregnate paper buildings. Okay, so because it will be give the good mechanical support to the conductor. Okay, to place hold the in the line. So for that to hold the conductor, that will be having the different. Okay, whatever the conductor, that is the conductor is there. So to hold the conductor, okay, we are using the so surrounding whatever the if it is having the two core. Okay, so two core if we place the conductor. So what we have to do, we have to defer the that. Okay, let me show you different colors of the core. Okay, it's a one type core. Now we'll have another type. So here are the two conductors. If it will be okay, if you have the three type of the conductor, right? So if this is the conductor, so if it is a cable, so what you have to do, whatever the core, three core cable is, so we have to insulate the three cores with different. So for that one, we have to insulate the these three. So these three is differ with the different, so it will be in a symmetrical spacing should be there as well as solid. Okay, whatever the insulation should be, because whatever the insulation is floating, so insulation should be is the not, so there is no leakage current flowing in between the two electrodes should be there. Okay, so while placing the single core, so it is for good mechanical support, but when we using the multi core, so it should be take care of the which type of the insulating material. Okay, how much strength of there. Okay, so we have to consider the mu R value. So mu R value should be in the minimum or maximum. Okay, so at what temperature we are using for solid dielectric, that we have to consider. So next we have in the so different types of the at what density we have in the dielectric strength. So here in the four types transformer oil. Okay, so we'll use the impregnation. So here we can see. So impregnation purpose, we are having the different types, right? So trichlorofluoride, okay, pentachlorophyte and transformer. For transformer, so mainly we are using the for high voltage application in transformer. Okay? So mainly the because if in the transformer type, okay, so we are whatever the core is made up of this there. Okay, so core is the core lamination there. So in between we are placing, so in between there we are placing the paper, right? So that paper we are not at the time. So while insulated by, so there is imprint. While it is the dipped into the oil. Okay, so if it's dipped into the, what happened that impregnation at that time the mu value will be different. So based upon the density. Okay, so it's based upon the density how much here. So either with the thickness either. Okay, so for centimeter cube how much density is there? Okay, based upon the density, the value will be different. Okay, so if you so as the resistance, okay, so whatever we have in the conductors there, so conductor resistance is based upon the thickness, right? Similarly, so whatever the length is there, okay, so length also take place for high resistance. Similarly here also density, okay, for the papers. Okay, so density is also plays the main role. Okay, let me talk the another thing is a fiber. So fiber is also one of the type. Okay, so fiber is a good type. So fiber also plays the good insulating medium in the electrical. So where we are using the this one. Okay, so in this one we are mainly which type of fibers we are having. So behind different types, that is a cotton, jute, flanks, wool, silk, okay, rayon, nylon, okay, teflon fiber. So based upon application, so it will be different, because for higher, So it will be the cost also the different. So if the cost is increases, what you have to do? So it's economical. So where we have to economical. So economical purpose. So we are using, so whatever the insulation, so that we have to use. So if you use the domestic purpose, okay, so at what time? Okay, so based upon the temperature. First we'll talk about the where we are using the application. Okay, so first they'll consider the application. Next, temperature. Okay, so temperature also one of them. And another thing, how much voltage? Okay, either you are using high voltage or low voltage. Okay, that will be the thing. So based on that, that will be different. So we are taking, while we considering the fiber, so these things, so application, temperature and voltage. So here, because if using the higher voltage range, okay, so if you're using the 66 kV line, okay, so 66 kV line cable, so what you have to know, which type of the fiber we have to do. Okay, so in that case, what we have to do, so based upon applications, what you do, Teflon, nylon, insulating fiber. So if you use the fiber glass, okay, in the solids, okay, so in the cables, we cannot using the fiber glass, right, to avoid. So in that case, that will be different. So fiberglass, right? So fiberglass mainly we are using, so in the transmission lines, okay, as well as distribution lines. So in the distribution side, nowadays what we are using, so some of the low voltage applications mainly. So we are using the low voltage application, the fiber, because it will be some the difference between the normal glass and fiberglass. That is, so whatever the glass we are using, okay. So glass, if we take the rectangular glass, so normal glass, what happen? So whenever it will be affected to the external source, what happen? It suddenly total breakdowns, right? But while coming to the fiber glass, okay, so fiber glass, what happen? It is having the glass properties, as well as it having, so due to the fiber glass, what happen? So it will have the some of the coating, okay, it will have the one plastic coating, okay, transparent plastic. What will do? So if it is any external force, it will happen, so it will be just cracked, okay, it does not break total, so it will be just cracked. So because, so it is act as a glass, but the insulating material, so it will having the increase compared to the glass, as well as the weight. So fiber glass weight will also differ, so weight is also less compared to the glass. Okay, so jute, so mainly in the low voltage application, okay, and economical. So for economicals, what we are using, so for cables, okay, jute material is mainly used in the dielectrical material in the cables, okay. So wool, silk, so these are the some of the application, okay, so these are the natural fibers, right? So this will be used in the some applications only for low voltage applications, okay. So here you can see, based upon the, so here the mu r value and is the temperature. So how is the dielectrical constants will differ from one temperature to another? So if the temperature is increasing, so to the 100, okay, 100 degrees centigrade, so whatever the mu value is there, okay, so it will also decrease, because it will be goes to the properties, whatever the atoms is in, okay, that will be different, okay, that will be affected due to the value. So to in that case, what we are doing, for at what temperature we are using, okay, that is all one. So that we have to consider at what, which applications we are using, okay, either we in for low temperature cases, either we are in the high temperature, okay. So for indoor application or outdoor application. Okay, based on that, we have to select the good insulating material. Okay, as well dielectric material. So here is the difference is that. So first one is the line is there. Okay, so one is the impregnate paper, one type. Okay, Trichope diphenyl, trial diphenyl, then pentadol, chlorofluoride. Okay, so that impregnate paper is different. So based on that, so if its temperature is increased, well, the dielectrical constant, your values will be changes. Okay, that is the constant value for higher values to lower, it will be temperature. If it is increases, what happens? The dielectrical constant will be decreasing. If the dielectrical constant decreases, means what happens? It goes to the breakdown condition. Okay, because so we have to use in the certain temperature applications. Okay, we have to choose correct dielectrical material. So here is another key. So when the density with the angle. So we have seen the phi angle, how it will be there. Okay, so you can see this. So here's the table. Okay, it's a good easy to know. Okay. So here it is that the properties of fiber materials. Okay, so we have in the fiber materials, right? So here is the tan phi is the one other thing. Tan. We are having another one, that is the mica and its property. So let me take the mica. So mainly the mica is used for main applications of the hydro. Okay, so if you are using the mobile phone also, there is a main thing is that mica application. Okay, mica is an insulating material. Okay, as well as heating element, right? So here mainly if you consider the mica is placed in main room. Okay, so based on the mica applications only, most of the electrical appliances work. So it's the one thing is that mica is that first thing is that this is the mainly used where we are using dielectric. So whatever the heating, so it will have the good properties, that is the it will be high constant, right? So it will be mainly used in the due to the crystal properties what we are being. So we are using the in the iron boxes. Okay, so in the iron boxes what we are using mainly the mica placed in the main room. So here we have the heating material, right? So heating, whatever the heating material is there, that's it. So if direct if not processed with the heat, so as well as do it will be protect our hands. Okay, whatever the applications there. Okay, so heating, and if it touches the body, what happened will be gone. To avoid that, what we are using after the heating element, we are placing the mica layer. Okay, so mica layer, what we do, so it will transfer the heat on. Okay, it will act as a good insulating medium in the iron box. So the electrical conductor, whatever the electric conductors are, that will be not poisoned. Okay, just wait. So here we have hearing, so mainly is that first, so mica insulation. Okay, mainly application we are using. So for domestic application we are using in the iron box. In iron box what you do, it is having the insulation. Okay, in the iron box what will be protect the ourself, okay, from the electrical shock. So if it is a mica, if it is failure, okay, if it's mica is failure, what happened? So we'll get the shock. So at the place you have to use, so we have to check either it will be broken or not. Okay, that is the one thing. So that is easy to know that where we are using the electrical appliances, the mica placed in main role for heating units, right? So it will be protected as a dielectrical medium from it. Okay, so it will act as the insulating medium as well as dielectrical medium in the iron boxes. Okay, this is the one thing. So mainly you are using, that is the just so introduction with the mic. So now we'll use the So we are having different types of the mica. Okay, so based on the crystal properties. So it believes in the crystal property and transparent, right? And it will have the muscovite, fulvite, fibrovite, lepidolite. Okay, we have the four different parts or types. Okay, so we'll done. So just we have to know the what are the different types. Okay, so not simple, but you have to know some of the in the examination purpose we are using. In examination purpose, it will be asked for competitive exam. So competitive examination purpose, it will be very useful because in the high voltage in learning. So where we are using the which type of the dielectrical materials, which type of insulation material that will, okay, that will be just for that one we have to know the that. Okay, just so let me talk about the glass. So glass is mainly used in the high voltage engineering. Okay, so because it will have in the main, okay, it is the cost is less. Okay, the mural. Okay, so the constant. Okay, the electrical dielectrical constant also is there. Okay, so because it will be having the dielectrical constant, it will be varies. Okay, based upon the conditions of the atmosphere condition, that is the 3.7 to 10. Okay, so density based that if you take the density 2.2 to 6 grams per centimeters. So because it will be differ, right? That will be differ from one to another. So because the why it will be varies from 3.7 to 10 mix. So which type of the glass? Okay, so glass also different types. Okay, so it will be fiber glass, it may be normal glass. Okay, so some of the combined with the glass is combined with the polymers. So because at that time we are using, okay, so some applications, okay, if using glass. Okay, so glass is the, so it is a one, so it directly is a glass. Okay, one type. Next we are combined with, okay, while manufacturing the glass, what we are doing, we are mixing the glass the fiber material and as well as polymer to get the lightweight glass. So that type of the right.